أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا مولانا رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وبعد فمع كتاب الله عز وجل ومع سورة القيامة الدرس الخامس. Today, inshallah, is our fifth lesson with Surah Al-Qiyamah. And I would like to start the Surah with an example that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us here in the next ayat. We're starting with ayah number 20. Somebody came to borrow my car because he has lost his car, or it was stolen, or it was crushed somehow. And now he doesn't have a car, and he really needs a car. So I lent him my car because I know for sure it's going to change his life, or at least it's going to make his life easier. He needs it like every day to go to work, to go grocery shopping. And then because I have another two cars, I don't really care about that one. So I left my car with him for 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, 2 years, and after 3 years, I went to ask him for my car back. I want my car back. And now because he has been dealing with my car as if it's his own car, he actually forgot about me. And he's dealing with that car as if it's his car, not my car. And when I went to ask for my car, he said to me, "How could you do this to me? It's actually my car. How are you asking for my car? It's not yours." And then I say, you forgot everything? I just gave it to you 3 years ago and you lost your car. He said, "No, it's mine. You're not supposed to take it away." That's exactly the example of a human being who loves this dunya so much, who loves his authority so much, who loves his son so much, or his children so much, or his car so much, or his house so much, or his health. And he's so attached to this world, and he forgets about the one who lent him this or this ni'am one day, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is giving us an example over here by saying, "Kalla, bal tuhibbuna al-ajila wa tadharuna al-akhirah." You human beings, you really love this world. And when he described this world, he used the words al-ajila. Ajila, when someone is running, is racing, he's on a hurry, he is hastening towards something, that's called ajala. So Allah is calling this world ajila because it's going to end very fast. And ad-dar al-akhirah is al-hayawan. Ad-dar al-akhirah is the world that will never end. This world ends, but the world in the akhirah never ends. Al hayawan, لو كانوا يعلمون. وإن الدار الآخرة لهي الحيوان لو كانوا يعلمون. سورة العنكبوت. فإذا ركبوا في الفلك. فإذا الله سبحانه وتعالى, after he was talking last time about how we should deal with the Quran. How we should deal with the Quran. And he said, you need to listen to it. لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه. You need that, after that, after قرآنه, after you recite it, you need to understand the meaning. فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانه. That was a message for رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, how to deal with the Quran. Now he's back, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to talk about the hereafter, and how people will look like in the hereafter. And look here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is basically describing their facial expression, how they will look like on the day of Qiyamah. He divided people into two groups. But before I go to this description, I would like to say, Allah is not saying we are supposed to hate this world. Nobody said that. If somebody sits down here one day and tells you need to hate this world, it's not Islam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَبْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. So we are in this world. We don't forget this, our portion in this world, our share in this world. But at the same time, you're working here, you're working so hard, huh, to provide for yourself and your family and to help others. But at the same time, your eyes in the Akhirah, not in this dunya. Your heart is not attached to this world, it's attached to the Akhirah. But you still have this dunya in your hand. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always, our scholars used to say this dua, Allahumma aj'al dunya fi aydina wa la taj'alha fi qulubina. Oh Allah, make this dunya in our hands, give us lots of ni'am, but don't let it go into our hearts. Because if you're attached to this world, you will forget about the Akhirah. But you're still supposed to work and be strong nation. Because you know what? We have been hearing this message a lot. The Muslims are not supposed to care about the dunya until we became a very weak nation. The weakest nation in the world now is the Muslims, subhanAllah. We're supposed to be the opposite. Because we have been hearing these messages. You don't have to care about this dunya. This dunya doesn't mean anything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means a lot. قال الله ولا تنسى نصيبك من الدنيا وعد لهم ما استطعت من قوة. Be strong in this world, as strong as you can, to compete with others. This dunya is all about competition, but at the same time, don't forget about الحيوان الدار الآخرة. طيب. These are two ayat, 20 and 21, and then ayat 22, Allah started to describe two groups of people in the day of Qiyam. قال وجوه يومئذ ناظرة. On the day of Qiyamah, the first group of people, their faces will be ناظرة. النظرة هي الجمال والحسن. You know when somebody takes a shower and he goes to the steam room or something, and then, or some woman, she's so beautiful, or a man who is so handsome. When you look at his face and you think it's very beautiful after making wudu or washing his face or something with a special kind of like soap and adding some special cream, it looks very nice, right? That's called nadra. This nadra, some people will look like this naturally on the day of Qiyamah. That's called the nadra. And a nadra, Nabi has made dua for people who make da'wah for Allah's sake to have this nadra in this world and in the Akhirah. Qala نَضَّرَ اللَّهُ امْرَأً. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give nadra to someone سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي, who heard my maqala, my hadith, my sayings, فَبَلَّغَهَا كَمَا سَمِعَهَا, and he conveys it, transfers the message exactly as he heard it. And that's why some scholars said you have to narrate the hadith with its wordings. You can't narrate the hadith with its meaning. Some scholars, not all of them. لابد من روايه الحديث باللفظ لا بالمعنى. هذا يعني some scholars, not all the scholars. Okay. And then he said, نَضْرَ اللَّهُمْ رَأَىٰ is making dua for those people, make dua to have nadra in their faces. So in the day of Qiyamah, people will have nadra. وَجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ, their faces will be nadra. And then he says, إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَ. It's agreed upon by all the scholars of Islam. Nobody disagreed in this. The Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Tabi'een and the schools of thought that the believers cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world, but they will be able to, Allah will give them the ability to see Him on the day of Qiyamah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us this ni'mah. Allahumma amin ya Rabbil Alameen. في حديث عن سيدنا أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أبي سعيد في البخاري ومسلم أن ناسا قالوا يا رسول الله. Some people came and said, يا رسول الله, هل نرى ربنا يوم القيامة؟ Are we going to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah? فقال هل تضارون أو تضامون في رؤية الشمس والقمر ليس دونهما سحاب. He's saying, imagine if it's a full moon and it's not, there's no clouds, not cloudy or anything, and it's a full moon. And you look at the sky at night, can you see the moon? You can see it, right? It's very clear. You're driving your car and there's no clouds and the moon is full, you can see the moon. And during the day, if there's no clouds and the sun, you can look at the sun, you can see the sun, right? He says on the day of Qiyamah, كَذَلِكَ تَرَوْنَ رَبَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. You will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same way in the day of Qiyamah. It doesn't mean that Allah is like the moon or the sun, but he's just giving us an example how clear the vision will be on the day of Qiyamah when you look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to grant us this because nobody knows how Allah looks like. The only thing that we know is that the Ba'asam says, رَأَيْتُ نُورًا. When he was in the journey of Isra al-Mi'raj, he says, I saw light. And in another narration, he says, رَأَيْتُ نَارًا أَوْ نَارًا أَنَّا أَرَى. Like it was so brightening. The light was so brightening that I couldn't even look at it. It's like nar. It's like fire. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah says, حِجَابُهُ النُّورِ وَفِي لَفْضَ حِجَابُهُ النَّارِ. The barrier between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His creations is nur, is light. And in another narration, nar, fire. It means it's not fire that burns. Fire, it means it's light, but it's a very brightening, very shining that you can't even look at Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's in this dunya. But in the akhirah, you can see Him. Insha'Allah ta'ala. That's wujuhun yawma'idhin nadira ila rabbiha nadira. And then the other group of people, wujuhun yawma'idhin basira. I don't know what to say actually about this. You know, basira, al-busur, huwa shiddatul ubusi wal-kuluh. You know when somebody is so upset at something? You know why I'm laughing? Because I have seen people like this. He can't smile. Some people can't put a smile on their faces. And some people think when you don't smile, people will respect you more. Do you think when you make da'wah to Allah, you shouldn't smile? Do you think that, you know, there is, we have حُبٌ فِي اللَّهِ وَكُرْهِ فِي اللَّهِ. Love for Allah's sake and hate for Allah's sake, right? And we said before, we hate actions, but we don't hate people. There are some people who spread hate for Allah's sake and they forget about حُب and love for Allah's sake. But Allah, when He started His Qur'an, He said, الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ. The most gracious, the most merciful, two words of mercy. He didn't say Ar-Rahman al-Jabbar. He didn't say Ar-Rahman al-Muntaqim. He didn't say Ar-Rahman al-Qawi. He didn't say the most powerful. He said Ar-Rahman al-Rahim. If what I'm saying is just a smile. Some people will be wujuhum basira al-busra. When you look at him and you see between his eyes, you'll never see it like straight. It's always, he's always not smiling. Like this. Some people are like this. I don't know why. Wallahi, even some imams and some du'as, do you think it's for my dignity? You know, if I smile a lot, people will think that I'm not mature. You shouldn't smile. Because if you smile a lot, you're not mature. Rasulullah, ma ru'ya Rasulullah illa mutabassiman. Nabi ﷺ has never been seen. Nobody saw him, but is smiling all the time. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Have you ever seen a human being like this? And some people, they are angry at everybody because it's against Sunnah, and he doesn't smile. Ya akhi, wujuhun yawma'idhin basira. Some people will have this facial expression that if payama busur. قال تعالى why بقى قال ماذا يعني. They are thinking that a faqira is going to hit them now. You know faqira means what? You know the backbone? It's called what? Amud faqri. Faqar. Backbone. So faqira in Arabic language, it's when a calamity or something very strong that hits somebody that he can't stand up because his faqar is broken. His backbone is broken. That's why you see me sitting straight now. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Allahumma inna rabbah. So they are scared of something that's going to happen. This day of Qiyamah is not normal. We haven't seen something like this. There's a faqir that's going to happen. There's something that's going to break our faqar now. And that's why they never smile. So when you see somebody not smiling, just ask him to smile, inshallah, in this world, to take hasana, it's a sunnah. And in the akhirah also, he will take hasana. And don't let him tell you that I'm just upset at some people because they are against religion. Spread love for Allah's sake instead of hate for Allah's sake. جزاكم الله خيرا وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.